Hello everybody, Nick here, and welcome to another episode of Polycraft. Today we are in my water temple right now because I wanted to show you guys a little bit of what this aesthetic is going to look like when we're done. We've got a little bit of a glass wall here going on, and kind of what I want to carry around the entire thing. Now, one thing about this, we do have a little bit of a wall situation here. We got a lot of gravel, and a lot of this wall kind of comes up around Water Temple rather than the Water Temple being raised up off the seafloor, so that's going to be a little bit of a challenge to work with. But anyways, you can probably tell with my hand right now, we got a little bit something going on here. But I'm blue creeper now. So yeah, what happened is I was watching XP Crafted stream the other day of Game Mode 4, right before he finished off the series, and well, yeah, he was making a graveyard, and apparently I'm buried in it. Because somebody decided that they were going to, you know, stuff a shell down my throat and, you know, choke me with it. Yeah, thanks for that. I like being, you know, choked with turtle shells and all that stuff, so. Yeah, so I'm blue now. I'm blue. Okay. Yeah, but anyways, we're not going to be doing some work over here in the water temple today, and I can't run like this because it's kind of weird to do, so yeah. Okay. Let's see. Parkour? Oh, no, not. I'm failing now. Okay. But anyways, I'm going to head over to the Dinoland village today, and we are going to be doing stuff over there, so, like, building a dock. So, anyways, I'm going to take a cut here, and I'll see you guys over there in just a little bit. Alright, so I'm back for a brief moment, and I just wanted to give you the idea of some of the supplies I'm going to be using for this build. Got some stone bricks, we got some of the stairs and slabs obviously to do the paths, we got some oak wood, got some brown stained clay, and some regular andesite and polished andesite, and it's gonna be the materials we end up using for the dock. So anyways, I think the first thing I'm gonna do are the paths. I'm gonna just probably do those ones off camera, and then I'll just cut back right away, so let's get that done first. We'll grab our stairs and our slabs, and we will get to work. Alright, so I'm back. And we got the path done here. Just wanted to show ya, and you know, it's a path. It's a thing. It's a path thing. So if you're walking from over here, from the portal, you can go this way, around the side, and go down here. And the path comes along the side over here. You can go into the dock building and go out onto the docks and go fishing or whatever. And then there's also this path here, which you can walk up this way. There's the Dinoland Tunnel, which I don't know if there's gonna ever be anything on the other end of that tunnel, at least not right now, but. And you can come up here, this Founders Park, although. Very colorful Founders Park, some interesting trees. I might get somebody over here at some point to, like, you know, make some custom trees for me. See how that would go over, and yeah, so Kind of interesting getting Squid to swim right up to the path. You know, got the half slaps here, which is pretty cool, and kind of like how this aesthetic is. So now we need to actually build the dock itself, which is going to be the more difficult part of this. And I'm just going to stuff as many stuff in here as possible. And I'm going to want some oak wood logs. And now, my shovel still. So what I'm kind of thinking here is, we have the land kind of this direction goes out a little bit, it kind of comes back in over here, so what I'm thinking is, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it's 17 wide, so what I'm kind of thinking is, from the end here, I'm going to go out a little bit of ways, maybe one past here, so that lines up with the edge there. And then we'll line it up here. Here. We are going to build kind of a pillar. Going to come across. Right there. Not going too far. I'm gonna go down again. And we're kind of gonna do the same thing here. Although I can't seem to right now, because logic. And it's kinda gonna just come over to the front and kind of make a little wooden structure here. The dock is going to sit on. And remember, oak is one of these few things I can always get more of it. It's not really that big of a deal. I'm going to at least do that. Make it kind of fit in a little bit better. Yeah, seems kind of good, although I'm gonna chop back this a little bit. Wait, so nice thing about this is most of this should become source blocks. The little work I need to do to make stuff over here source blocks. And I think these three sandstone, I'm gonna take those out. Yep. And it's going to float in the cave below. I don't want that, so we'll just block it off for now. We're gonna source block everything. Awesome. So yeah, as you can kind of figure out, I don't have depth strider boots. And that is because when I was working on the water temple, a guardian decided that it wanted to kill me. And because it decided it wanted to kill me, it decided to take my boots with it. I thought this was an odd number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. 18. We're making this long number. You're gonna be 19. And it's just like, I'm moving this up for one. Alright, so we're still gonna do the same sort of thing. It's just gonna be moved over one. Also allows us to move this over one. Kind of have a little bit of a staircase towards the middle here. Just press the old wood, okay. I'm gonna do that. And from the center here, do something like that. Something like that. And then this will kind of be where the stairs are to get up to the dock itself, and there will be a little bit of a building on it, and then they'll also get other stuff going on. So I am going to switch over to the oak wood stairs. Gonna do kind of like that, so we can get up to the platform. And the platform itself, I think I want to just do some oak half slabs with some fences around the perimeter, kind of like this. And like, this. And I think that will get us a pretty good aesthetic for this building, so. Still flowing. There's a source around here still flowing somewhere, but I'll ignore it for now. We'll see how long it takes before it starts bugging me, so. Yeah. Anyways. This is gonna be a little bit boring to watch, so I think I'm gonna put in a little bit of a cut here. And why do I need to say that every time I put in a cut? Okay. So it's gonna actually be that full thing. And this is where I'm going to want to polish the underside, actually, I think. Join it up with the fence here, I guess. Is that fine? Yeah, that's fine. So this is kind of going to serve as the walls for the little building here. Kind of an andesite bottom. Are going to need a way in within the center here. Just put a stair like that. Door will be here. Take out that. There will be a stair here. And that'll get us like 1, 2, 3. Maybe we can put another. Yeah, just 3, I think. Because it's already. Or we could put 4 in the corners, I suppose. But yeah, it's going to get crowded in here pretty fast, so. And I really don't have a lot of fishermen villagers at this point anyways, so not too concerned about it. But yeah, you know, the areas where he keeps different villagers, I want them all themed to, you know, their kind of occupations, so That's kind of why I'm doing it this way rather than just, you know, put them all into one building, because I think this is kind of a slightly cooler way of actually doing it. And what other material are we gonna use? Because I'm already running low on oak. Have the brown stained clay, which I think is gonna serve us to be like the base color here. Make some kind of tall windows on the front, or put some small windows on the back. And then we are going to need to designate some spots for the villagers, kind of like there. And some stairs to kind of keep them in. Like that. Can even do that. Yeah, have some spots for two villagers here. Not that bad. And so when you're in here, you can click on the villager and trade with it and stuff like that. So yeah, it's a small building, but you know. And we got this open space out here to work with. We can make an actual part that goes out into the water, which I think I'm gonna do over here. Although we do need some more oak wood for that, so I'm just gonna kinda note that this is gonna be here. And I can come in and support this later. So, kinda like that. Kind of juts out into the water here. I'm gonna go a little bit further than I have here, but you know. Can make a little bit more wood for right now. We'll just turn that into a whole bunch of slabs. And I think one more. Yeah, that's good. And at the end here, we're gonna have some poles coming up, kinda like these over here in the corners. And that'll kinda be our frame of what holds this up, this part up, so yeah. Of course, I'll have to go get those logs and everything, but. Ah! Thought you could get up on half slabs. There we go. So yeah, second layer of this, I think. And I think some kind of windows in the sides, just small ones. And then around the back, too. One more layer of this. And that's kind of gonna tie everything up. So, yeah, we got two. Oh, nope. Got two villagers. Oh, no. Don't do that. One over here, one over here. Click and trade them. I keep clicking. Shovel. I can't break anything with a shovel. Yeah, so there's one here, one here. They're both gonna be fishermen. They're gonna get transported in here, put into these little slots. I can then keep the trap doors I have if I have the trap doors on. Right here. And we can do something like that. I like that though. Or door. Don't have any glass right now because, you know. Who needs glass anyways? And we can do kind of the same thing on the sides over here. To dress up all the windows on the outside. Yeah, I like that. Inside here, we can put, like, maybe, like, a flower pot or something on those ledges, or do something with that. I don't know just yet, but... what else are we gonna do? Obviously, we need a roof for this thing. And I think... go with the polished andesite again for kind of the top of this building. Now that I kind of get myself from having way up here. And I think we'll just use regular andesite for the ceiling inside, not stone andesite. Use a little bit of the andesite if I can, wherever I can. I have loads of the stuff. I mean loads of this. Like, I almost have a chest full of it at this point, which is getting a little bit on the crazy side. You know what, we want some light inside of there, so we'll grab some sea lanterns. Actually, I want you there. Kind of hidden lighting. One there. I'm in the water again, in case you didn't notice. Fish. Yeah, I think that lights it up nicely. And keep. Once a villager there, you're not going to really be able to see the sea lanterns, either. So I'm fine with that. You know what, you need to also prevent the way for mobs to get up here. Can't put trapdoors on that. Darn. That was gonna be part of my aesthetic, but yeah, the rest of this I think we're gonna use like some of these chests. Can kind of make a little bit of a chests. Gonna put them down a little bit. For the main reason it's easier to do this than to try to do it the opposite direction. And underneath right now. Some regular chests kind of here and here, the trap chest in between, and we can use some of our brimstone clay that we ran out of, so we're not going to use it. How about we use some polished andesite? Go. One up there. So can you do something similar to the other side? It's a little bit different because we have here you walk around over here. A few chests, places to put stuff. Ooh, I like that. Just a little bit of detail. And what else? So yeah, kind of a little bit of a blind spot. You can always put more villager stalls outside too. It's always a possibility, but yeah, I kinda like this. I can run around the dock a little bit, out here is a little bit plain. We could use maybe some crafting tables, maybe add a few sideways logs or something. But like crafting bench or two. You know what would look good here. I did that again. If you want to watch somebody fall into the water 20 different times in an episode, come watch me. If you want to actually watch somebody do something meaningful, don't come watch me. Because reasons. Kind of like that, and I don't have this material with me. So I need to go back to the nether and we're grabbing some rails and some spruce logs. Because reasons. You know, always reasons. Reasons is the best reason for anything. Because if you have reasons, what other reason do you need? Our rail. Grab a little bit of you. Head on back. Something a little bit like so, like this. Well, not like that. Although we will need you. But not like that. Like that. Like that. One, two, three. Uh-huh. So we got a little bit of wood pile there, and got a little bit of a little craft area here, what else could we do to add a little bit more detail to this, let's see, what else did I bring with me? Some ladders, maybe? I like that better, it's just solid, stuff, so we'll keep it how it was. Maybe on here, though. Yeah, that looks good. You know, decorate up the pillars a little bit more. Give it a little bit more detail, make it look a little more wooden. I mean, though I am using some stone. You know, because there's nothing wrong with mixing materials a little bit like that. Only thing I have left to do with this dock is, get this stuff out here done, because I don't have the materials for that, and I need a roof on you. Stone roof, maybe? I feel like a wood roof would look better. I'm gonna do a wood roof. See, am I gonna land on there, or nope, definitely not. Hi, squid. Hello again, squid. And that one should be good. Or not. That one should definitely be good. There we go. Alright, so, wood roof. I think I'm gonna go this direction. Kinda like this. Shelf. That gives us another row. And then we'll fall. And we'll ender pearl. And we'll fall again. And we'll ender pearl. I was about to say we'll fall again, but I didn't fall this time. And we need a shelf. Not there though. Here. You're gonna be wall. Make you andesite wall. One there too, because that's gonna be like that. And yes. You know what? We are going to fill you up with a whole bunch of andesite, because hey, guess what? We have so much of this stuff, we can just do that. And it's not going to deplete our resources pretty much at all. So, yeah. Do that, and do that. And that way we have a little bit easier of an area to work with that one. Top, we have a little bit more to do here. And we need an underside there. And one over here. And then we'll just kind of do this. Not that. This, like that. We'll go back over to the other side and we'll do the same thing over there. I can jump onto this fence. You know what? We can just do this. Alright. That looks pretty good, I think. A little simple. That's fine, simple's good. sometimes, you know. Got a few torches in the front. Light up a little bit. Back doesn't really need it. Got torches over there already. And you got a little bit of rough. We got an area to put our fishermen in, and with really no problem. We need some glass for the windows on this, but other than that, and the oak wood over here, but other than those two things, and die zombie. But anyways, I think I'm gonna, you know, gather that and do the rest of this off camera, so you guys pretty much know what it looks like at this point. And I'll just, you know, end the episode here, so and grab this yummy XP, even though we're at like 50 levels already. Because hey, we can grab some yummy XP. But anyways, thank you guys for watching, and more Dead Creeper. See you guys next time.